a desperate plea for forgiveness. Tonight, a convicted drunk driver is begging a judge to reduce his 12-year prison sentence. Justin Hill was driving in the wrong direction when he caused that crash that killed Ashley Madison back in 2010. KOCO's Michael Seiden is live with that story. Michael?
I thought initially when he was sentenced, I wouldn't be in this place again, and I feel like I've been re-victimized.
Ashley's mother thought it was over, but now she's headed back to court to face the drunk driver who caused the crash that killed her daughter.
I have not received a letter saying he was sorry. So in that same time and effort that he's using to show people that he's changed, he hasn't acknowledged what he's done.
Instead of an apology, she's received a desperate plea from Justin Hill.
I see this letter as self-serving, completely self-serving.
In this handwritten letter, Justin begs the judge to release him from prison. He writes, quote, "I am so very sorry and I take full responsibility for what I did." He also writes about his behavior. "I have been promoted to the highest privilege level in the fastest amount of time possible, and I have not received any disciplinary write-ups."
I don't need him to write this lovely 2.5-page letter about all of his accomplishments and things that he's done in prison. What that tells me is he's doing it for a reason, to get out or to get something lessened.
Hours before her death, Ashley Madison and her band entertained a crowd at the Riverwind Casino. On the way home from her performance, Justin Hill sideswiped the car she was riding in, causing the driver to slam into a retaining wall, instantly killing this accomplished musician.
I just want him to stand up, be a man, accept his responsibilities for what he did, and not try to get out of it.
That was Michael Seiden reporting. Ashley Madison left behind a 4-year-old son and a teenage sister. As far as Justin Hill, his attorney told us that he will be in court on Monday.